applaud me for being on here with these edges need to be laid down and all types of shenanigans. Have you propped up in the corner this light? Only thing that's working for me is don't ever give up on your dream thing. You know, where there's a will, there's a way. So for all of that, you should stay with me because I give you the real deal, Holyfield. It is the end of the night and I shot this video, but I realized your girl didn't do no intro. But we need to do an intro for this video. So, if you're new to the channel, I am Tyann, and I am on a journey to wholeness. And you did not find me by mistake. You found me for a reason. You were looking for something, and you found it, and I'm it. So subscribe and go through this journey with me. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with somebody else who needs the motivation. Testimony, I was not happy in my relationship. And so there were things going on that I wasn't happy about, but because I was in my mind blessed to be a stay-at-home mom and I didn't have to work, I felt like I shouldn't say anything. Who are you to talk when you're not working? Not realizing that being a stay-at-home mom is a full-time job, that I was doing everything. So instead of telling my significant other like, yo, that's not cool. You can't hang out with your friends that late. You can't do that. I would just eat. I call it Little Debbie in it. Instead of saying what I felt, I would Little Debbie it. And when I said, like, get donuts and stuff like that and just drink juice and just be up in the middle of the night watching Seinfeld, just eating,
you know, food comas are nice. Little Debbie in is nice.
But it's not. It's terrible because your soul is not getting out what it needs to get out. You are still mad at that person. That person don't know why. He asked you, did you need anything? And you said, yeah.
That number two with extra cheese. He was like, oh, okay. And then you got an attitude in the morning. I brought her Big Mac. What is she upset about, Jesus?
So you have to speak about those things in a nice, calmly way, you know, at good timing, and then tell people how you feel. But you eating it is making somebody else abuse you that sometimes they don't even know that they're abusing you because you didn't say anything. I believe that we get into these situations, especially with weight, is because we're not happy. We're not happy. We're not happy in some area in our lives. We can't speak on it, so we eat on it. And I know that just sound like
you remember that show with Eddie Murphy when he was just like eating
whatever your weight is, circle it and say, I'm thankful. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. I'm thankful for awareness. I thank God for awareness so much. Because I was so unaware. I was so unaware that I could do anything, say anything, be anything. I just thought life was just given to me and I had to take what was given to me. I didn't know that I could go in there and be like, nah, but this is
my life. It's my life. I can do what I want. I'm a big girl now.
That no, if somebody loves me, they will join the choir of me. Okay. Think about that. That's deep, right? Right. See y'all in the next. Bye.